Coming up on Pierce County News.
What that will mean is no weekend service at all.
Pierce Transit plans big cuts. Highway 167 could get a missing link. And a fun run reunites mom and daughter. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radel. Bus service in Pierce County is about to face deep cuts. After voters narrowly rejected raising the sales tax to pay for bus service, the transit board will soon cut some important services.
Every day, more than 30,000 people in 14 cities in Pierce County rely on Pierce Transit buses.
I'm really depending on the bus.
But starting in September, Pierce Transit will cut bus service by 34%.
What that will mean is no weekend service at all, limited service past 7 p.m., and limited midday service.
For Jenny Gonzalez, who often works on the weekends, the cuts will take a big toll.
I go to school and go to work in Seattle especially, and I don't have any means of transportation but Pierce Transit.
Danny Velades says he may have to find a new place to live when they cut service.
They need to find another revenue stream, something, because this is going to force a lot of people that are disabled or handicapped to move from Pierce County, because you can't get around on the bus anywhere.
Pierce Transit says it has considered other options, including raising fares. But with 56% of bus riders living below the poverty level, a hike could price them out of the system.
So when you increase fares by even a quarter, which may seem pretty reasonable, you're talking potentially of, you know, $60 a month. And to somebody that earns less than $20,000 a year, that's a pretty big impact.
The transit board will listen to public input on the changes over the next several months, with the cuts scheduled to start in September.
Highway 167 never made it past Puyallup. After 30 years of talking about it, this could be the year we see funding to finish the missing link to Tacoma. Finishing 167 could ease congestion in one of the fastest growing areas of the county and create a direct route for trucks headed in and out of the Port of Tacoma. Executive Pat McCarthy says leaders in the South Sound want to see this become the top project in the transportation budget.
I believe there's a lot of support there, and it will be a series of, we formed a coalition, Denny Heck is leading it, and I have a seat at the table.
Lawmakers are already discussing where they'll find the money to pay for the extension.
You're not going to get enough revenue through tolls and through other hot lanes and other ways you would necessarily derive revenue from those kinds of, solely from those activities. It's going to require state funding and maybe federal funding as well, but it's going to require a lot of stakeholders.
New numbers out this week show the housing market in Pierce County could finally be turning around. According to the Northwest Multiple Listing Service, home sales rose more than 5% in Pierce County last year compared to 2011. The median home price rose to $195,000, up from $194,000 in 2011. Local realtors say the upward trend seems to be continuing this year.
All the metrics we use, pending sales, actual sales, number of listings. I mean, just in my office, you know, the number of transactions that come across my desk, just the buzz and the energy in the office, you know, is clearly suggesting that we're heading in the right direction after a long, long 3-4 years.
Larson says home prices in the county seem to have hit bottom, and homes that are priced right are selling fast.
I mean, you need to be priced pretty well, and if you're a buyer, you need to be ready to go, because otherwise you're going to miss out.
New construction is also on the rise in Pierce County. Pierce County Planning and Land Services issued 319 new single-family home permits at the end of last year. During the same period in 2011, 186 single-family home permits were issued. This month, permits are already up more than 50% since the same time last year.
Just mainly it's residential and businesses, and businesses are always the ones that will lead the way. If we have more businesses going into place, that means more people are coming in, so they're starting new businesses, and that means that follows along with that, new houses, and then the tenant improvements start coming in and stuff like that. We are gearing up for that. We've hired actually two new people.
The numbers are strong for commercial, industrial, and tenant improvements, but Director Dennis Hanberg sees pent-up demand in single-family residential.
So we're trying to stay ahead of the curve by basically making those positions permanent. So we hired both an inspector and a plan reviewer to try and keep up with current workload. So far they're doing that. We're only a few weeks into the new year, but we're definitely busier than we were last year.
The county is seeing most of the new development in South Pierce County between Meridian and Pacific. If growing your own fruit trees sounds like fun, but you don't know how to care for them, a new program is here to help. Joining me today is Emily Garofalo. She is with the Pierce County Gleaning Project. Emily, what is the Gleaning Project all about?
So the Gleaning Project is a collaborative project with the Pierce Conservation District and the Tacoma Community Gardens. And we work to harvest food that would otherwise go to waste and get it to those in need. So we harvest from farms, from farmers markets, and from backyard fruit trees. And this past year, we've picked about 60,000 pounds of food for those in need in our community.
Oh my gosh, wow. Well, tell me about the fruit tree program that you guys have going on.
Yeah, so the fruit tree program is a new program starting this year, and we're working to educate people on fruit tree care and maintenance. And the goal is to maintain our urban fruit trees that we have all around us. We have about 100 registered fruit trees with the Gleaning Project, and we'd like to continue harvesting them throughout the years. So the goal is to have participants enroll in this course, and they'll learn various fruit tree skills over the course of 6 months from February to June.
What specific things will people be learning in the classes?
So it's really a diverse class series. People will learn the varieties to plant in the Pacific Northwest. They'll get to graft their own fruit tree to take home. They'll get to learn how to create a food forest. We'll do summer and winter pruning, pest management, really a lot of different classes. And every class will be hands-on, so people will have the opportunity to get the knowledge and then put it to practice.
Oh, I like that. Now, what should people do if they want to sign up?
So they can contact me, and if they're not interested in doing this program but would still like to be involved, we have lots of volunteer opportunities, and people can also register their fruit trees with us to be harvested.
Oh, sounds good. Thanks so much for coming on today.
Thank you.
Well, with below freezing temperatures this time of year, Pierce County road crews are busy spraying anti-icer on major county roads. Our winter weather is typically cool and wet, and that can mean some difficult driving conditions in the morning. Black ice can form overnight when the humidity is high but the temperatures dip below freezing. Road crews apply a liquid anti-icer one day before that kind of weather is expected. They target hills, bridges, and major intersections to prevent ice from forming. The application can last for 4 days unless it rains or snows. For more snow and ice information, visit the road maintenance website. Coming up next, see how a race brings a mom and a daughter back together. We're back in just 60 seconds.
I vow to make excuses when you humiliate me in public, to forsake my friends and family when you isolate me, and to value myself less when you belittle me. I vow to blame myself when you hit me, and to fear for my safety and the safety of our children till death do us part.
Don't ignore domestic abuse. Speak now. The Family Justice Center is a place of safety.
Pierce County Parks and Recreation recently held the No Sun Fun Run, where for one girl, she was set up for the surprise of a lifetime. Megan Hutton has more.
300 runners arrived thinking this race would be like any other. Sign in, get your number, and wait. Even the weather was perfect for the No Sun Fun Run. But in the crowd was a 14-year-old girl who didn't know something special was about to happen. And it all started with a phone call.
We've got a really great surprise. She doesn't know her mom's coming in. Can you help us? And I was like, of course we can.
Keep your eye on Kelsey in the red sweatshirt. The race got off without a hitch as runners wound their way around Heritage Recreation Center in Puyallup. If you ask Kelsey's guardian, she was more excited for the race to be over.
This is our fourth deployment as a family, and Kelsey's been with us for the last year, and it was just a way to end her year with us and surprise her and show her how much we love her.
I am here to surprise my daughter, just returned from Afghanistan.
After runners crossed the finish line, a one-year deployment would no longer separate this mom and daughter.
I've got the best kid in the world, and I just cannot wait to see her.
Can I get Kelsey Dixon up here for a sec? We found something out on the trail for you.
Little did Kelsey know that during the award ceremony, there was a special award waiting just for her. A hug can be so powerful. No words are needed when you haven't seen your mom in so long, and you hoped she would come home safe. And you can tell Jennifer is surprised by how much her daughter has changed.
Awesome. Short.
Yeah. So we're like the same height here.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
Up next, find out which Olympic medalists are coming to town. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. The Chambers Creek Regional Wastewater Treatment Plant is expanding, and you're invited to learn more about it. The Sewer and Water Utility will be hosting a public open house about the project on January 31st. It's happening from 5 until 7 p.m. at the Environmental Services Building. If you want more information, call 253-798-2421. Do you want to be notified if an emergency or disaster strikes? Sign up for Pierce County Alert. It's a free service that allows police, fire, and other agencies to send you accurate, up-to-date information. From severe weather warnings and road closures to safety hazards, get the information directly to your phone and email. Sign up online at piercecountywa.org or call 253-798-6595. This week, Kyle Wintermute has the scoop on the biggest ice show of the year. Hi, Kyle.
Hi, Heather. Hey, are you looking for something a little bit different than this year's blockbuster movies? Well, look no further, because you can come to this year's Reflections on Ice, Once Upon a Dream. This Pierce County favorite is sure to take you away to a time when childhood dreams almost seemed real. Starting Friday, February 8th, through Sunday, February 10th, the Lakewood Winter Club will host this ice show spectacular, starring Olympic medalist Ben Augusto and U.S. national champion Rachel Flats. Tickets are now on sale, so don't wait. Stop by Sprinker or call 253-798-4000 before they're sold out. With so many holiday ice show specials on the TV, have your kids been begging you to give them a chance to learn how to ice skate? Wait no longer. Get them signed up for Learn to Skate classes today. Sprinker's ice skating instruction program has received ratings of 10th highest in the nation, so you can be assured you'll be learning from some of the most highly qualified ice skating professionals around. Call or go online for more information. So let Pierce County Parks and Recreation entertain you this winter. Call or go online to get tickets today. I'm Kyle Wintermute for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Looks like a lot of fun. Thanks, Kyle. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. If you want to know when the latest news stories or council meeting video is available on our web, sign up for email or text alerts. Just go to piercecountytv.org and click on Notify Me. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.